While Anzac Day is, of course, a time to reflect on the service and sacrifice of those who've gone before us, it is also a day dedicated to those currently putting their lives on the line to protect our country.
Yeah, HMAS Adelaide is actually the largest warship in the Australian Navy fleet, and today reporter Gabrielle Boyle got to head on board.
The final leg of a long journey through Sydney Heads and safely home. Sunrise from onboard HMAS Adelaide. Sailing into our sparkling harbour, it's easy to see why homecomings like this are special.
When you are out at sea for a while and then come back, it's pretty emotional coming back through the heads and knowing that you're home again for a few days or a week or however long it is that you're here.
But for the men and women who work on board the mighty HMAS Adelaide, it's not all postcard moments. And that's why we've been choppered in, to give you a look at everyday life on board.
Cast my ship's head around to a course of 310 and then start closing onto our planned route.
At 230 metres long and more than 27,000 tonnes, HMAS Adelaide can carry a crew of up to 1,400 people.
We can operate 6 helicopters from the deck at one time, but we can also have aircraft stored in the hangar as well.
There's helicopter hangars, an almighty underground garage, a fully functioning hospital, a gymnasium, and while the accommodation isn't 5-star, it's certainly tidy.
In my 450 ships company, they are from all corners of this great southern land, male, female, black, white, all different genders, races, accents. You know, I have a small hospital. I have enough bunks for 1,500 people. I can produce 6,000 meals a day. I can produce enough electricity to power a town. There's a lot going on, yes.
In the kitchen, these cooks can whip up a whopping 6,000 meals a day.
Hungry boys and girls.
Absolutely, especially when it gets to the end of the day and it's close to knock-off time.
We've got Indian night, it's beef vindaloo. It's quite delicious. Most of the time you end up coming home a little bit more plump than you enjoy.
And you can wash it down with some green cordial, I see.
Yeah, we got lots of cordial.
Do you ever wish you could wash it down with a glass of wine?
Oh, sometimes, definitely.
So when you get back onto land and you have to cook for yourself, it's a bit of a letdown?
Yeah, a bit of a hassle.
What does Anzac Day mean to the servicemen and women on board this ship?
Generally, it's a time for reflection and remembrance. I remember a number of mates that I've lost along the way. I look back at previous generations. I think about what they've done, the sacrifices they made. And I also look at what we, the current generation, are doing in defence of our country.
But there won't be much rest for the guys and girls on board HMAS Adelaide. They're in Sydney for just a couple of days before they hit the high seas again. Their next destination is Brisbane. They're expected to arrive on Anzac Day.
Just remembering all those who served before us. It's always special at the dawn services, especially in Sydney.
It's a bit of pride, I guess, and honour to serve after the people who served before me.
And we thank them for their service.